Good afternoon. On this 25th anniversary of Time for Reflection, our Time for Reflection leader today is Jim Wallace, the Right Honourable Lord Wallace of Tankerness, KC.
Presiding Officer, it is a very much appreciated privilege to have been asked to deliver this Time for Reflection on the 25th anniversary of the first ever Time for Reflection given by the Scottish Church's Parliamentary Officer, the Reverend Dr. Graham Blount, on the 27th of October 1999. But I'm also conscious that today is the first plenary session of Parliament since the death of the former First Minister, Alex Salmond. As a contemporary of Alex Salmond in the House of Commons, in this Parliament, and as respective party leaders, I can testify to his formidable skills as a politician and recognise the service he gave to his constituents and to Scotland as an MP, MSP, and First Minister. And my sympathy goes out to Moira and Alex's family, not least today as he's laid to rest. Indeed, I think it is timely to recall with appreciation the service given by those who have been elected to this Parliament over these last 25 years. And whatever their politics, the contribution they have made to their communities and to the commonweal. There's a passage in Mark's Gospel which is etched in my memory and hopefully taught me something about service. The reason I remember it is when I took my confirmation vows over 50 years ago, the minister, referencing my baptismal name, James, referred to the exchange between Jesus and James and his brother John. The brothers, James and John, asked Jesus if he would appoint them to sit on his left hand and on his right hand when he came in glory. Clearly, they entertained notions of earthly or political grandeur. And the other disciples remonstrated with them for getting a bit above themselves. But Jesus didn't scold them. Rather, he set out the exacting demands of discipleship. And Jesus continued, "Whoever wishes to be great among you must be your servant. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." And at a time when politics can be so polarising, surely a common commitment to service, whatever our faith or creed, is something that can unite us. And I conclude with the words from Graham Blount's prayer 25 years ago, which I think are still apposite today. God of grace, we pray for our Parliament, offering our faith and our vision, that this may be a place where folk can come when they have no one else to turn to, a place of listening and of healing and of hope. And we pray for one another, for folk we see as friends, rivals, colleagues and opponents, aware of the pressures and the failings and the possibilities we share. Amen.
Thank you for that.